Walter Elias Disney. It is one of the most well-known names mentioned across the world every day. Known mainly for his world-famous theme parks, Walt as a leader had accomplished many different ideas before his passing on December 15, 1966. In 1923, the biggest accomplishment of all, in my opinion, took place. Walt Disney opened the doors to the Walt Disney Company in Los Angeles. While there, he created some of the most iconic characters that we all know and love today. In addition to opening his own animation studio, he embarked on the mission to create a couple of firsts in the industry. In 1928, Walt created Steamboat Willie, the first cartoon to have sound dubbed along with it. Almost 10 years later, in 1937, Walt released Snow White and the Seven Dwarfs. This ended up being his first full-length animated feature. Also, in Disney's lifetime, he set out to design and build two theme parks and a community of tomorrow. Before Walt's death, he opened Disneyland in 1955 in Anaheim, California, and began the process of Walt Disney World in Lake Buena Vista, Florida. Thanks to his leadership skills, he was able to raise up a team that would eventually open Walt Disney World for him with help from Walt's brother, Roy O. Disney. Also, his team took his idea of an experimental prototype community of tomorrow and built the theme park Epcot. Walt Disney's successful career coincides with the chapters from one of John C. Maxwell's books, Developing the Leader Within You. In my opinion, Walt possessed all of the attributes, but there are a few that stood out over others. Walt faced the challenge of losing the rights to a cartoon character he had created, Oswald the Lucky Rabbit. Instead of letting it get the best of him, he showed his team problem-solving and how to create positive change by developing a new character, Mickey Mouse. In that situation, he could have let his attitude get the best of him, but he again showed his team positivity and creativity. When designing and building Disneyland, Walt Disney was doing something that most thought he couldn't pull off. He stuck to his vision, and with the help of his friends, family, and his staff, he managed to create a theme park like no other. Throughout all of the stages of Disneyland, from the drawing board to the finished product, Walt faced many challenges. He was determined, though, to make his vision a reality. So, he set his priorities, used his problem-solving skills, and accepted the change that would unexpectedly come up in order to keep the vision alive. After all of the ups and downs, Disneyland opened to the public on July 17, 1955. On opening day, due to the number of guests, Walt was able to show his team participative management style by helping transport water and food across the park to give to guests. Out of the five levels of leadership, Walt Disney was within level 5, personhood and respect. He was at level 5 for multiple reasons, all of which were mentioned in the Maxwell book on page 16. Throughout Walt's life as a leader, he spent those years mentoring and molding leaders. Walt may not have known that he was doing so, but he raised an army of future leaders. These leaders aren't just employees of Disney, but he inspired other theme parks across the world to come to life, from Universal to Six Flags. Once he opened his animation studio, he became a statesman and consultant and was sought out by others to draw cartoons for them. Finally, the biggest thing that put him within level 5 is the fact that his followers were loyal and sacrificial. They would do anything they could for Walt, one of which would go by different names and lie to property salesmen in order to purchase the land for Walt Disney World. In conclusion, Walt Disney could be considered one of the greatest leaders in history because he created opportunities that other leaders didn't, invested his life into his work, and transcended the industry.